Good morning, my dear friends. So today in the sessions we are going to learn 14 problems on the compressions electrical springs. The first of all, I will read the question. The counter recoil of a gun is to sustain a maximum compressive load of 29,700 newton. So here the maximum compressive load 29,700 newton is acting. Okay, the initial compression load is applied when assembled with the gun is firing position. So the here in this case the initial compression is found to be 200 mm. So in this case the initial compression, the value or the y is given as 200 mm. Okay, the spring is made of rectangular bar of chrome vanadium steel. So this spring is actually it's made of rectangular bar of chrome vanadium steel. Okay dear, the longer side of which is 4 times the shorter side. So this means that the longer side of the spring equal to the 4 times of the shorter side. So longer side it is represent the B equal to 4 times of shorter side, it's represent the H. Okay dear, B equal to 4H. The spring is formed when the shorter side parallel with spring axis. Okay, design the spring if the travel of the gun during the recoil is, so the initial position of the coil is how much is there, Y1 equal to 200 mm, and the final in which Y2 equal to how much is given here, 300 mm. Okay dear, the clearance between the coil should be 6.25 mm. So here the clearance value A equal to how much is given here, 6.25 mm is given. Okay, when deflected to the maximum amount the spring should be stiff. When the spring index, so a spring index, the C value is given as 2.5. find the free length LO, as well as we need to find out the pitch of the spring, we need to find out. Okay dear, the first of all we have to write down the given data. Okay dear, so let us see here. The counter recoil of a gun is sustained a maximum compression load, how much is given here, 29,700 newton is given. The compressive force F equal to 29,700 newton. Okay, as well as the initial compression load is applied when the assembled with the gun is firing position, and initial compression is found to be, so the here the initial compression, the value is given here, Y1 equal to 200 mm. Okay dear, the spring is made of rectangular bar of chrome vanadium steel. Okay dear, the longer side of which is 4 times of the shorter side. The longer side it is represent the longer side of the spring it is represent the B, and the shorter side it is represent the height of the spring. Okay, B equal to 4 into H. Okay dear, after that design the spring if the travel of the gun during recoil is, so this here Y2 is given here, the Y2 equal to 300 mm. Here Y2 is given 300 mm. Okay dear, the clearance between the coil should be 6.25 mm. So this means that the clearance it is represent the A equal to how much, 6.25 mm. Okay dear, and when the deflected to the maximum amount the spring should be stiff. When the spring index, the C value is given as 2.5. The free length, we need to find out the free length as well as pitch of the spring, we need to find out in this problem. occur here. So this is the compressive force is given here, 29,700 newton. The initial compression value is given as 200 mm, and the longer side should be equal to 4 times the shorter side. It is represent the B equal to 4H. Okay, M is equal to B by H. Okay, equal to 4. M is modulus given, so we have to refer the page number 171. Equation number is 11.13. So the final compression value is given as Y2 equal to 300 mm. Okay, the clearance between the coil is how much is given? 6.25 mm. The first of all, what we need to find out in this case, first we need to find out the total deflection of the spring. We need to find out, okay dear, okay, the total deflection Y equal to Y1 is indicate that it is the initial deflection, plus Y2 is indicate that it is the final deflection. Okay, so the initial deflection, okay, how much is given here? The Y1 value is given as 200 mm, plus Y2 value is given as 300 mm. So if you add this value, 200 plus 300, then you will get the answer is 500 mm. So after that, so in this problem, it is given as the spring is made of rectangular bar of chrome vanadium steel. Okay, dear. So for that reason, we have to go for the chrome vanadium steel. Refer the table number 11.5, page number 191. Then you will get the value of yield stress. How much? 900 megapascal. And modulus of rigidity you will get 0.07845 into 10 power of 6 megapascal. So in this case, the factor of safety n equal to 2 we need to assume. Okay, after that we need to find out the actual value of shear stress. We need to find out the working shear stress of the yield point. N equal to yield shear stress by working shear stress. N equal to yield shear stress, it is represented by tau y. By working shear stress, it is represented by tau. Okay, dear? Done. So here, in this case, the N value, the factor of safety is given. Meanwhile, yield value, okay? Yield stress, we can say, yield stress value is given. How much? Yield stress value is given as 900 by N factor of safety is given as 2. If you divide 900 by 2, then you will get the answer is 450 megapascal. If you want to convert in Newton per mm, you can convert in Newton per mm square also. Okay, dear. After the getting of working shear stress, we need to find out the value of Wall's factor. If you want to find out the value of Wall's factor, you have to refer this equation 11.13a, page number 171. Then you will get this equation. K is equal to 4 into C is indicate that it is a spring index minus of 1 by 4 into spring index minus of 4 plus 0.615 by spring index. Okay, dear. Then 4 as it is. So the spring index value, so how much we got here? 2.5 minus of 1 by 4 into 2.5 minus of 4 plus 0.615 by C. The spring index value is 2.5. then if you divide the whole the value with the help of calci, then you will get the answer is 1.7746. that is the value of Wall's factor. After the getting the value of Wall's factor, we need to find out the value of mean diameter of the coil. If you want to find out the mean diameter of the coil, you have to refer the spring index formula. The spring index formula is C is equal to capital D by small b. So this C is the spring index. How much is that here? 2.5. so capital D by small b. So in this case, we do we know very well this B value is 4 times of H. Is it right? It is already given in the question. So 2.5 as it is, wherever the B is there, we need to put the value is instead instead of B, we have to put the value is 4 into H. Okay, then 4 into H. Just you need to multiply the value 2.5 into 4, then you will get the answer is 10H, because H is unknown value. Okay dear, so you need to consider the equation number 1. Okay dear, after the getting of this one, then you need to find out the value of H. If you want to find out this value of H, then you have to refer the formula of shear stress in a rectangular cross section spring. For that reason, you have to use the equation 11.13a, page number 171. Then you can easily find out the value of H. Then let us see how you will find out the value of H. This tau is indicate that it is a working stress equal to K, the Walls factor, and how much force is acting, into mean diameter 1.5 height plus 0.96 into breadth by B square into H square. Okay dear, K, the K value is how much is given here? Already we have found out how much, 1.7146 into F is already given in the question. The force F is given as 29,700 value is given, into the mean diameter is given as here the D value. We need to put here D instead of D, you have to put the value is 10H. 1.5 as it is, H plus 0.96, wherever the B, we have to put the value of 4H, by wherever the value of B is given, you need to put the value of 4H whole square into H square. So after that, so if the bases are same, the power should be added. Here the power is 2 plus 2 should be how much here? It should be 4. After the getting the H power of 4, you need to cross multiply here. Okay dear, and if you cross multiply, this 450 will divide toward right side. Okay, 1.746 into 29700 into 10H, 1.5H plus 0.96 into 4H by, so it's the 4 square, 4 square nothing but it should be 16. Okay, into here this should be 450. After that, let us see here H power of 4, here H will be there. Okay, now dear, just you need to divide this whole the value first, 1.746 into 29,700 into 10 by 16 into 450, then you will get the value is 72.02 into H as it is. The remaining terms should be this much. Okay, 1.5H plus 3 point, if you multiply 0.96 into 4, then you will get the answer is 3.8484H. Okay dear, after that, this H and this H will cancel, the remaining term should be H cube equal to. Okay dear, you need to multiply the term 72.02 into 1.8, then you will get the value is 108.03H. plus you need to multiply 72.02 into 3.84, then you will get the answer is 276.5568 H. So here H and H terms is common, just need to add this value. After the adding this value, then you will get the value is 384.58 H. Okay dear, after that, toward H is there, toward H also H will be there. Just you need to cancel these terms. The remaining should be H square. H square is equal to 384.58. If you remove the square, it is make as root. It is make as root, or we can say as it's a make of 1 by 2. Then, if you divide this, if you're taking the root value, then you will get 19.61 mm. So after the getting the 19.61, you need to substitute in the width of the wire here in the equation number 1. Then B equal to 4 into H. Here equation number 1 is there. Okay, B equal to 4 into H. You need to substitute here. Okay, 4 into h. 4 as it is, h value, how much is we got it here? We got the value is 19.61. If you multiply 4 into 19.61, then you will get the answer is 78.44 mm. After the getting the value of B value, you need to substitute, because we need to find out the diameter, mean diameter we need to find out. So for that reason, we need to substitute in the equation number this second. So D equal to 10 into H, we can say D equal to 10 into H. 10 as it is, H value is how much we got here? 19.61. If you multiply, then you will get the answer is 196 mm. After the getting the value of B and D and H, you need to substitute this whole the value in the deflection formula. Okay dear, so we have to go for deflection y equal to 2.83 into I is indicate that total number of coil into how much force is acting on this spring into mean diameter cube into width of the spring square plus height of the spring square by B cube, H cube, G nothing but modulus of rigidity. Okay dear, the y deflection value is given as 500 equal to 2.83 as it is. So I values, the total number of coil is unknown, we have to keep as it is. Force, the force is value is already given in the question, how much? 29,700 into D. So D already we have found out here, how much? 196 cube. Here in the bracket B square, so breadth is already we have found how much here? 78.44 whole square plus H is how much? 19.61 whole square by B nothing but 78.4, here Q will be there, keep as it is, 19.6 cube into the modulus of rigidity value is given as 0.07845 into 10^6. So if you multiply the whole the terms, then you will get that much answer. After that, we need to divide the whole the value, then you will get the answer is 14.519 into total number of coils. So I's indicate total number of coils. So if you divide this value 500 by 14.519, then you will get the answer is 34.53. So 34.43 should be approximately equal to 35 mm. So that is, I is total number of coils should be, how much is that here? 35 of the spring. The number of coil of the spring is how much? 35. After that, we need to find out the number of the turns we need to find out. If you want to find out the total number of coil, I equal to I plus 2. So I already we have find how much here? 35 plus 2. So if you find, then you can easily get the 37 turns, because above should be one more turns, below should be one more turn. So if you add 35 plus above 1 plus below 1, should be how much here? It should be 37 mm. After the getting the total number of coil, we need to find out the free length of the spring we need to find out. If you want to find out the free length of the spring, we have to use the formula is LO equal to. LO is indicate that the free length of the coil, or we can say as free length of the spring should be equal to, I is indicate that total number of coil plus 1 into height plus Y is indicate that deflection. What they indicate? Deflection. Plus A is indicate that clearance between the coils. Clearance between the coils. It is represent the A value. After that, keep yellow as it is. I value, how much we got here? 35 plus 1 into height. How much we have to consider here? 19.6 plus Y deflection value is how much we got here? 500 plus the clearance between the coil is how much is that here? 6.25. If you multiply the whole the value with the help of calci, then you will get the answer is 1211.85 mm. After the getting this value, because we got the free length of the spring, again the next case what we need to find out, the most important is we need to find out the pitch. If you find the value of pitch, then you will get the full marks. Okay, dear. So what is the formula of the pitch? How to find out here? So first of all, you have to refer the table number 11.4, page number 189 for plane and ground end. Free length should be equal to initial, or we can say as total number of coil plus 1 into load, or into pitch. Okay, dear. So free length already we have find here 1 plus 1 into h. Okay, 1 plus 1, but for the free length we need to consider this value, this 1 plus 1, okay, plus y plus a equal to I plus 1 as it is, P also as it is. So this P is indicate the pitch of the coil, or pitch of the spring, we can say. So if you find out this value, it should be equal to how much here? So I miss the small term here, I plus 1 into H. Here H will be that here, remember. Okay, so this should be equal to LO. Okay, this should be equal to LO, equal to I plus 1 into P. So LO value is how much is that here? 1211.85 equal to I value is how much will be that here? The number of turns of a coil is given as 35. Already we have solved 35 plus 1 into pitch. So if you divide this whole the value, then you will get the answer is 33.66 mm of the pitch of the spring of the coil. I hope so. We got the value easily. Free length of the spring of the coil, how much is there? 1211.85, and the pitch of the spring, how much we got here? 33.66 mm. I hope so. No one is having the doubt regarding this class. If you have the doubt regarding this class, please write down in the comment box, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel here. Thank you.